Hey everyone, Ian Van Tuyl here, and behind me is a new listing of mine in San Diego, California. This is a 2015 Jeanneau 57 yacht. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this vessel has to offer. Okay, so here we are looking at, seriously, the 2015 Jeanneau 57 yacht here in San Diego, California. This particular vessel was bought new by the current owner and has been between Newport Beach and San Diego. It's currently at my docks here. I just had the decks completely resealed, and it looks absolutely beautiful. The hull was just buffed. The top sides were just buffed and waxed as well, and it is in prime condition. One thing that the Jeanneau 57 offers is the large tender garage. So this garage door here in the back opens up, giving you an amazing swim platform on the backside of the vessel, and it allows you to install a pretty nice sized dinghy in there. I believe the current one is almost 9 feet. It will fit 4 to 6 people comfortably. And the outboard is right in the middle, but I'll show you some pictures in the full listing. We have a nice boarding ladder here. As we come onto the vessel, we have the hot and cold shower. We have our 50 and 30 amp shore power inlets there. Off to the starboard side, as you can see, there's a full lounge bench seat cushion here. There's a backrest that was custom done, but we are at the starboard helm. And here at the starboard helm, it's quite nice because we have our main sheet winch and our general winch here, both electrically assisted by 2-speed Harkin winches. We also have our electronic throttle system. The throttle system itself is quite nice because it is a really nice touch and feel to it. Windlass chain counter. This allows us to deploy and retrieve our anchor. And then we also have what's very unique to the 57. This is the very first model year that they installed it, but the bow and stern thruster combination. So again, this gives you the peace of mind to be able to spin the boat in a circle, directly side tie it to a fuel dock. This is a nice upgrade. We also have our Volvo Penta full engine display here. And then as we look center compass, we have our lighting, spreader lights, deck lights, and then our head sail furl in and out controls. We've also done something unique as we've added them to the port side helm as well. Multi-repeater and autopilot display. Centrally located is the glass front Raymarine display. This is a nice large unit display here. We have a multi-repeater, and then as I mentioned, this second electric head sail furling switch. So again, depending on what tack you are, you can retrieve by furling in and out the head sail from right here. Again, 2-speed Harkin winches, both for the main sheet and the Genoa sheet. Deck fittings for spinnaker blocks and attachment fittings. But the Jeanneau 57's cockpit is pretty impressive. We have access to the dinghy garage located here, and access to a life raft locker located underneath this seat. We have upgraded speakers throughout the cockpit. Those are the Fusion speakers. And again, a really nice cockpit, big, large seating, backrest here, large cockpit table. Inside the cockpit table, there is a fridge compartment, and forward of this is a like glove blocks. Up here on the cabin top, we have a 2-speed Harkin rewind winches. And again, so this makes it really nice. We have a 2-speed section and the rewind when it's switched into this to allow it to kind of come in and out. Now, why you would want the rewind on this side is the nice thing about it, if you have your outhaul here, you can actually electronically push in and out the outhaul so you can adjust the sail shape on that. And then we also have the Harkin rewind winch off to the port side as well. Moving up to the fore deck, we have this really nice custom dodger here. There's a sunshade that's removable. This current owner just really loves to be out in the elements and sun. And so again, when he's sailing, he takes that down. But this is the macro long glass, a built-in stainless steel grab handle here. You notice that there's a really nice, easy pathway up to the foredeck. Nice inboard shrouds. And again, all the sheets and halyards lead aft into the cockpit. Large sun mattress up here on the foredeck. And then as we move up further, we have access into the forward V-berth that can also be used as crew quarters if so desired. Large Lumar windlass here, double bow roller system, Fackenor furling system. And again, down here in the anchor locker, you can see we have all chain, and then there is a washdown. But the teak decks came out absolutely beautiful. The guys here in San Diego do a great job. And again, here's a nice view looking aft. Coming up, we have a triple spreader mast. Radar is fully enclosed in a stainless steel guard. And this is a keel stepped mast. Moving back aft, a couple things I want to point out is the standing rigging. This is all diaphragm standing rigging. So we have a really strong high-end rigging found throughout the vessel, from Harkin magic blocks there to all of the high-end Dyneema lines. It's definitely built for a serious offshore cruiser. And again, you can look at the size of this cockpit. It is really impressive. All right, so I'm gonna take you on down below. First thing we're gonna see is just how open and beautiful this yacht is. This is brought in with the teak interior, the light oak floors. The nav station is off to the starboard side, and the galley is off to the port. Now, one thing about this being that it's a master aft, the galley has actually been extended. And what I mean by that is, instead of having a door access straight through here into the second aft cabin, you have the second return, additional shelving, additional storage up here. We have the Bose speaker system, lots of cabinetry. We also have a three burner stove and oven that I doubt has ever been used. Overhead vent hood, and again, LED lighting throughout. This is the lacquered cabinet tops that were new to this year. Built-in microwave. We have a full top-loading refrigerator, side-loading access to the refrigerator, and a top-loading freezer compartment as well. Double stainless steel sinks here, a nice dish drying rack outboard, and again, really beautifully done. Lots of storage throughout. Generator is located just forward of the engine, and it's a sound shield along with an isolated compartment there. Again, directly across from us is the nav station. The nav station set up quite nice. I really love how Jeanneau's done this. They've done a second plotter here, and then we have real easy access to these components, allowing us to turn on and off our lights, our refrigerators, our navigation by a push of a button. And then we go into the technical cabinet here, which allows us to breaker all of air conditioning, inverters, outlets, start the generator, inverter controls, and so forth, and transfer switches. Great amount of storage found, again, throughout the vessel itself. Nice leather-wrapped nav station. And underneath here is access to additional storage, or you can put a washer and dryer, and then a foul weather closet right there. This has the upgraded chocolate leather interior. And as you can see, this has been really tastefully designed and decored down below. There are four overhead opening hatches, just really flooding the salon with natural light, great ventilation. Over here to the port side, we have a wine cabinet that's integrated in there. We have our Fusion stereo control system here, our Bose surround sound system, and the Sony Blu-ray player. The vessel is equipped with air conditioning and heating. There are multiple zones in all the cabins, allowing you to have heat and or cool, which is quite nice. The center salon table is on an electric lift, and so by a push of a button over there, you can actually lower this down to turn it into a coffee table, raise it up for a dining room table, and then there are leaves on both sides allowing you to have a large dining table here. These are the upgraded director's chairs, quite tastefully done. Again, these will collapse, fold away, and stow if not needed. As we move up to the forward cabin, this is pretty unique. And as you can see, we have two access doors here because there are a couple different ways that you could set this cabin up. Right now, as we see it set up as the partial VIP cabin. And the reason I say partial is because this lower unit here, this leaf, actually, when this door is closed, this will lift up. There's a filler cushion that slides out so you can make a full queen size berth here. It allows you to have a really nice Pullman style berth here. Lots of hanging cabinets, storage around, again, air conditioning, heating controls. And then you have a nice bench seating area with a vanity, additional hanging locker closet. Now, the wall itself that's actually installed in this area is stowed underneath the bed. And so when the wall is in place, this bench seat now turns into a double bunk bed. And so again, it gives you lots of versatility. If you have multiple couples on boards, or if you have, you know, a family with kids. So again, they could have the bunk beds up. They can have the VIP cabin set up. You have two heads. This would obviously be the VIP cabin head. It has a plexiglass shower door that encompasses the shower itself, and Japsco electric quiet flush toilets. These also have been converted to salt and or fresh water flush. So by a push of a button, you can energize both the salt water pump and or fresh water. So it allows you to kind of pick and choose. And then on this head and cabinet, the same thing. This is more of a wet head, and then gives you access up to the V berth and or crew cabin. So if you wanted to use this as a crew cabin, this door would shut, this door would lock, and then the crew themselves can gain access from the top and then have their own head and shower and really nice V berth up forward. Again, lots of shelving throughout. There is a storage locker both to starboard and port side. The one to starboard, this one is a little bit larger in use, but again, great use of space and a really nice layout. I find this to be one of the most versatile layouts, again, just because of what it really offers. But the vessel's been kept in really amazing condition. There is low, low use on it, and it's only been here in Southern California. It gives you a nice view of, again, these director's chairs and the table itself and the fabric, the materials. Absolutely stunning. Okay, so now I'm going to take you into the aft master cabin. This particular cabin is set up really impressively, and we are going into a full center line queen berth. This is pretty unique in its design. Not a lot of boats do this, and really you commonly see this in center cockpit boats. But starting out onto the starboard side of the vessel, this door comes off and just opens up. Now you have a full hanging locker closet. Two doors that open up, additional storage and shelving below that. But again, they've done a really nice job of integrating that leather inlay into the cabinet itself. And then now as we move aft, we have a forward-facing desk or vanity. Nice large bench seat here for seating. Tons of storage around. Really nice reading lights there. And a really nice bed with an upgraded mattress. Directly forward of this, you can have a TV installed if you so desire. We have engine room access here. We have shelving throughout. There is a massive large cabinet storage design over here that you can see from top loading to underneath to the sides that open as well too. And then we have access into our private head and shower. Again, Japsco quiet flush electric toilets, saltwater flush, freshwater flush, your choice. And then as we move in, we have a full shower compartment, again, with the plexiglass door that encompasses this large shower compartment. And again, just really is tastefully done with its materials. Corian countertops. And again, you look at the faucets and how the sink has been laid out. It's really nicely done. The other thing I like to point out is just all the attention to detail with the high-end door hinges that are fully adjustable and really solid build, real thick doors. We have a lot of natural light back here as well too in this cabin. And then again, large opening hatches throughout. So you get great ventilation back here in this stateroom. Well, I hope you found this short video to be helpful and informative. We covered a lot of boat in a short period of time. There's probably a lot of things I missed, but click the link below to give you the full photo shoot. There's probably 100 plus pictures of that. And then again, please feel free to call me at any time, day or night. I'm happy to answer all the questions that you might have. I've spent lots of time on the Jeanneau 57 and definitely have been through the factory and all of the systems, so I can definitely be your source and your consultant through the buying process. Again, and please feel free to contact me. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel. Thanks again. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.